to number one in the homework. Nice and loudly and clearly and slowly. All right, Nadi.
A is Y. B is Z. C is X or Z. D is Y at 62 degrees. E is 118 degrees. F is 62 degrees. And G is 118 degrees.
Awesome. He is right on target. All right, good work. Now I need a volunteer for number two to do just what Nobby did. All right. Kendall?
A, Y, B, Z, C, yes, D, no, E, 40 degrees, F, 140 degrees, and G, 40 degrees.
Perfect. Beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful. Now, Hope, can you give us answers to 3 and 4?
13 degrees and 56 degrees.
Now, is there anyone that is unclear about something on the front page? We should be using our grading pens right now. Is there anybody who's unclear about something on the front page? Kevin?
13 and 15 degrees. 113 and 146.
Okay. Okay, so let's look at number three. We'll start with number three. Okay, so Brendan, what's your thought on that?
So basically, since it's a straight line, you have to get to 180. And if you can tell, one of the lines is 167. So you would subtract, but I added, you would subtract. But I just know in my head, so I just put 13, because you do the math out right, it would be 180.
So what he's saying is, we know that a straight line makes 180 degrees. So since we already have 167 there, do 180 minus 167? Okay, well, I think somehow you got an extra one in there. The ones cancel. When you do 180 minus 167, when you do 180 minus 167, look, you even got a pass. That's the way you do it. Thank you, Marie. We're going over our homework. So 180 minus 167. Kevin, you know you're doing your borrowing thing, but 1 minus 1 is 0, so there's no 100 there. Didn't you say you got 113? Yeah. So, and then in number 4, that little box like symbol means 90, right? So we're going to take 90 minus 34. 90 minus 34. Because of the box thing, right? That's a 90. All right, let's look at the back side. Who will give me answers to 5 and 6? Brendan?
100 degrees.
Perfect. 129. Yes. Ben, did you have a question?
No, how do you know 7?
Actually, 7 and 8 are graphs, so we can't really describe them. Well, maybe you can. Well, why don't you come up and graph them, Ben? Number 7 and number 8. So we got a visual for those. Anybody want to share an answer to number 9? Let's see. I got all the same people raising their hands. All right, Hope, what do you have for 9?
I got 8.
Okay.
I don't know what I was doing.
Well, I didn't get 8. What did you get, Mariah?
I got 9.
That's what I got. Yeah. We're going to do that one, Hope. Okay, we're going to do that one so we figure out what you did wrong.
Wait, where are we on?
Number 9 is negative 7.
I thought you were...
But we're going to do number 9 since we have some people missing.
Yeah, that's what I... Yeah, yeah.
Number 10 should be a less than. Yay. That is the symbol you should have in number 10. If you are confused about that, I want you to keep in mind that you can add a 0 here to this one. And with negative numbers, this sounds so weird, but with negative numbers, the bigger they are, the smaller they are. So since 5 is bigger than 0, that number is actually less than because they're negatives. That's a less than. Anybody get an answer to 11? Maurice?
Oh, I have a question.
Yes.
I forgot my folder at home and I have my homework in it. Is it okay if my mom could bring it to the school and I just send it to you?
Well, it's late, so it doesn't, you might as well just bring it tomorrow. It's going to be worth the same points tomorrow. Now, if she wants to bring it when she comes and picks you up, that's okay. But I'll take it tomorrow, okay, since it's already late. Okay, so who got an answer to number 11? All right, Kendall?
Not 16.
16 is what I got too, 16.
For what?
Number 11. Come on, let's pay attention, number 11. All right, number 12. Brendan, get an answer?
5 and 13 15s.
That is the same as 88 over 15. That is the same. And mixed numbers are fine. They're fine. But it's the same as 88 15s.
It's so much easier to do that. Right?
Easier is one of those words that what's easy for me isn't easy for you. So if it's easy for you, do it that way. Okay? But understand they're both okay. All right, number 13, percent of decrease. What did we get for that one? 13.3%.
Actually, I did it though.
Number 14. Come on, you're marking these wrong, and we're going to come back and talk about them, but we got to get moving. Number 14. Why do I have the same people raising their hands? Kevin, what did you get for 14? Oh, now be careful. We have formulas. Oh, we got to look at these two, 7, 8. We have formulas. Circumference is 2 pi r. Kids, you have to know these formulas. So put them on flashcards, have mom and dad drill you, but you need to know these. Circumference is 2 pi r. If the diameter is 10, then the radius is 5. So 2 pi r would be 10 pi, and the inch or the thing is centimeters, the unit centimeters. Now, area is pi r squared.
Yes.
So that would be pi times 5 squared, 25. Or 25 pi square centimeters.
I got that.
Area is square centimeters. All right. And then the last one is a little commission problem. What did we get then?
I got 1,875.
You got it right. Yeah. And that's dollars. $1,875. Okay. Now, let's quickly double check 7 and 8. Then I know we need to do 9. And then we'll do whatever else you have a question about. Problem 7. Open circle at -4. Closed circle at 1.
Yes.
You know one of my favorite questions to ask along here is, is 1 a solution?
Yes.
And you would say yes. Is -4 a solution?
No.
No. Is -6 a solution?
No.
No, because -6 is out here. Is 0 a solution?
Yes.
Yes. Now, how come we all know that now? We got to remember that on Friday, okay? If it's colored in or shaded over, it is a solution. If it's not colored in or not shaded over, it is not a solution. All right. Number 8. This is one of those tricky ones. This is actually correct. But this is tricky because this says 3 is greater than h, which means h is less than 3. Make sure if it's pointing at the h, when you turn it around, it's still pointing at the H. That is exactly correct. Good job. Okay, number 9, because we had a question about that one, and then we'll do whatever else you have a question about. Number 9.
Can I solve it out?
Actually, I'm going to give you a chance, Navi, to do some stuff, but this one, let's just get it done real quick here. We need to solve this equation. When I say the equation to myself, the x side of the equation, it's 3 times x plus 1 divided by -4. The last thing I say is the first thing I do. So since it says divide, or undo, I should say, since it says divided by negative 4, last, the last thing I said, I'm going to multiply both sides by negative 4. Now, on this side, that completely cancels out, and all you have left is 3x plus 1, period. The 4 is gone. On this side, we have 5 times negative 4, which is negative 20. Negative times positive is negative. Now, 3 times x plus 1. Got to get rid of the 1. So I'll subtract it from both sides. So 3x equals negative 20, negative 1, negative 21. Right? Then I divide by 3. Now, Hope, I think you're the one that missed this the first time around. Does that make sense to you? Now, who else has something we missed and need to talk about?
Number 11.
Number 11. We are dividing by a fraction. Remember, when we divide by a fraction, what we really do is multiply by the reciprocal. So this is 12 over 1 times 4 thirds. When we divide by a fraction, we multiply by its flip. Now, you can cross cancel, or you can multiply straight across. So straight across would be 48 over 3. And 3 goes into 48 16 times. Or if you cross cancel, 3 goes into 12 4 times, and 4 times 4 is 16. Either way, the answer is 16. Okay?
Could you do number 12?
12, we are adding mixed numbers. Now, you can do this in a couple of different ways, but we have been changing our mixed numbers into improper fractions. Working with mixed numbers can be a little tricky, especially in subtraction, multiplication, and division problems. Addition isn't too bad, but the other ones make it really complicated. So we just kind of said, all right, when we have a mixed number, we're going to change it. So our improper fraction here would be what?
11 over 3.
11 over 3. Our improper fraction here would be 11 over 5. Now, some of you might get excited. Look, they match. It doesn't matter. It's not the tops that have to match. It's the bottoms. That's right. So we have a 3 and a 5. What's our common denominator?
15.
So times 5 here, times 3 here. We only need common denominators when we add and subtract, kids, not when we multiply. When we multiply, we do not need common denominators, but when we add, we do. So we have 55 fifteenths and 33 fifteenths, which gives me 88 fifteenths. Now, if you want to change that back to a mixed number, you can, but that is perfectly fine as an answer. All right? As a mixed number, it was, what did you say? Somebody gave me a mixed number.
13 and 15.
13 and 15. Okay, that's fine. All right, anybody else? All right, make sure your name's on those and pass them up, please. And now we have, you already have your notes, so we're ready to go with those. Make sure your name is on your paper, please. Remember, if you have zeros, people, tomorrow morning is the absolute deadline for getting that stuff made up. Okay, so I gave you this homework.
Oh,
I gave you this homework a little bit ago, so some of you may have already gotten started. All right, so here we go. We're going to interpret graphs. Read some graphs. Did you get one of these, Maurice? Here. All right, so here we go. What category takes up most of the money? So this is your weekly or monthly budget for your family. What category takes up the most? Ben?
Housing.
This is a circle graph, right? And it shows how things compare to the whole. Did you get one of these, Moses? Okay. What three elements make up 50% of the budget? Hope.
Utilities, food, and housing.
Perfect. And how did you know that?
Well, I added the percents together to equal 50%, and then I got it.
Okay, and can you look at the picture and see the line that cuts it in half? Goes this way, and there's three items on the bottom, the one she said, utilities, food, and housing. And then what about the four on the top? Don't they also add up to 50? Yep. How much more is budgeted for utilities than investments? 6%. Kevin?
6%.
Yep, and how did we know that? What did you do? What arithmetic? You subtract. When it says how much more, we think about subtracting. All right, now here comes the tricky part. The family brings home $8,500 a month. How much is spent on housing? Navi. Be careful. You actually don't divide it by 0.2, you multiply it. Remember, when we are doing arithmetic with percentages, we always take the amount times the percent. So it will be 8,500 times 0.2, 1,700. So we take the amount times the percent. Amount times the percent. So it's 8,500 times 0.2. All right, the family brings home $7,025 a month. How much is spent on food and transportation? So what's the first thing we need to do?
Add
together food and transportation. So if we add food and transportation, what do we get? 33%. So we are going to multiply 7025 times 33%, which is 0.33.
And you get
$2,318.25. Yep, so $2,318.25. $2,318.25. You can get a calculator now, obviously, you can type it in on your own. The family saved $100 for the month. How much did they make for the month? Oh, this one is tricky. Let's talk about this. Yes, Brenton. Yes, it's going to involve a division. Because here is the deal. X is how much they make for the month, right?
Yes.
So X is the monthly income. So how much is the investment? 7%? So 7% times X is $100?
Yes.
So to figure out what the X is, we're going to have to divide. To find the amount, we have to divide. So we're going to take 100 divided by 0.07.
$1,428.57.
And it's, 1,428.57. That's how much they bring home for the month. A family paid $225 on food. How much did they spend on savings and investment? All right, guys, this is a tricky problem. Let's start with food. What percentage is food?
17.
So 17% times something is 225. So X is their monthly income. Okay, so we'll divide. And this family makes 225 divided by 0.17. So they make $1,323.53. That is their monthly income. Now, savings and investment. What percentage is savings and investment?
That would be 16%. If you add them both.
We add them together, it'd be 16%. So 16% times 1323.53 is the answer to the question.
That would be 211.6 cents.
Oh, my calculator's getting weird on me. Is it 211?
76.
76. Calculator's going crazy now too. Okay, those are a little tricky. Let's see what's on the back. Birthday of students by month. Wow, June has the most birthdays, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And actually, I have four children and two of them have June birthdays, so half of mine. Any of you have June birthdays?
I have an April birthday.
Anybody have a December birthday?
Jesus.
All right. How many students have an August birthday?
One.
How many more students have a June than a March?
I think it's eight.
June has 10 and March has 2. What month has the most birthdays?
June.
What 2 months have the same birthdays?
February and November.
You can tell that because the bars are the same. What month has one more birthday than December?
May and October
both have the same also?
Yes, they do.
May and October. What is the total? Oh boy. How are we going to find the total number of students?
Add them all up.
So January is how many?
Three.
February is?
Four.
Two.
Nine.
Three.
Twelve.
Eight.
May is eight. Ten. Six. One.
Seven.
Eight.
Four.
And seven. All right, so let you add these up and I'll add these up and we'll see what we get. That's what I got, Navi.
Yes, I didn't discover.
What is the total number of students?
That's the total number. I got 63. But Navi matched me, so I think I'm right, but
yeah,
I could be wrong.
Yeah, you guys are right.
Is that what you got?
I forgot I had a heavy
litter. All right, now listen. There are 63 kids all together. How many have a November birthday? Four. So to find the percentage, we're just going to take 4 divided by 63. So that would be 6.3%. 6.3%. What percentage have an April and December? So let's see. April is 3. December is 7. So that will be 10 divided by 63?
Yeah.
So 15.9?
Percent?
Yeah.
What percentage of students do not have a September birthday?
That's 7.
So if we do 7 divided by 63, that will be the number who do, which is 11.1.
Yeah.
So the ones who don't would be 100 minus 11.1,
yeah.
Which is what, 88.9?
Percent?
All right, here we go. We're looking at the next one. These are firefighter fatalities by age. Oh, how awful. How many firefighters died between the ages of 26 to 30?
Eight.
What age group has the highest death rate?
51 to 60.
Dang. What age group has the lowest death rate?
Under
21. Hope you're paying attention, Angel.
Yeah.
How many more firefighters died at the age of 36 to 40 than 21 to 25?
Seven.
Now wait, how many more died?
Seven. Is it 14?
36 to 40 is 14. Yep, and yep, you're right. 14 minus 7. You are right. What was the total number of firefighters?
Oh,
well, we got to add them up again, right? So 5, 7, 8, 9, 14, 11, 12, 18, and well.
91.
I got 96.
96.
I got 96. Did you use a calculator? Help me out here, folks. You guys with calculators.
I didn't add that
5
at the end. Yes. It's
96? All right, so E says, what was the total number of firefighters? So the answer is 96?
Yeah.
All right, F. What percentage of firefighters died at over 61? Now, how many died over 61?
12.
12. The total is 96. So we're going to take 12 divided by 96, and it's 12.5%. Everybody follow that? 12.5%. Yes, because when you type it in, you get a decimal. Yep. Yep.
What's that?
12.5. What is number F? What percent died at 31 to 35 and 46 to 50? So 31 to 35 is 9, 46 to 50 is 12. That's 21?
21.
So 21 divided by 96?
Yeah.
21.9%.
Yeah.
21.9. What percentage of firefighters died that were not under 21?
91.
So it's
91 times?
Okay, now, Navi is doing it a different way. He says the number of firefighters not under 21 was 91. You see how he got that? 96 take away 5. So he's doing 91 divided by 96. To find the percentage, you divide by the total, okay? He got 94.8. Now, what's another way to do that problem? Navi did it by taking 91 over 96. What's another way you could do it? Could we do 5 divided by 96? And that's 5.2%. So 5.2% was under 21?
Yes. No.
So 100 minus that?
So it's 94.7.
It's
12. Yeah. Look at the age group breakdowns. What do you notice? Remember, kids, with a line graph, you see trends. What trends do you notice in this picture? Overall, the older they get, the more they die. Now, not totally, because it does go up and down a little bit, but overall, doesn't this curve go up? So the older you get, the more you die. All right, great work. Tonight, you will get to practice that. What we are going to do now, though, I told Navi he had a chance to come to board, and he does, and all of you do.
Yeah.
I'm going to give you your homework, but right now, we're going to do this.
Don't even start.
Okay. I want everybody to get out PC or paper. Remember, we have we're supposed to have notebook paper with us or some kind of paper. And we are going to take, we're going to spend 10 minutes doing a quick little review of basic arithmetic. So I have put on the board a division problem and a plus problem. I need, Navi gets to choose which one you do it, Navi. Ken, don't you do the other one?
I'll do the other one. He's doing the divide one. You'll do the add one.
Now, what should the rest of you be doing right now?
Writing it down.
Writing it down and doing it. So I don't need to see an iPad out. All right, use it as a calculator, okay, but nothing else. We're practicing, so Craig, come on, let's go get these written down and let's do it. Girls, grab these paper, let's go. We're doing basic practice. Oh, by the way, guess where I'm getting these problems?
Our quiz exam.
From the final exam.
Oh,
now, these aren't the exact problems, but they're problems just like the exact problems, okay? So we want to make sure we don't miss this simple little stuff.
Oh,
Oh, it's the same problem.
Is that 49 or 43?
One is a divided by and one is a plus, but the numbers are exactly the same.
How are the numbers?
Oh, wait.
Is that a 49, Bobby?
Wait, what?
Yes, his is a 49.
That's not a 3.
I haven't done it yet. I'm going to do it right now, Brendan, okay? So you can go ahead and sit down and start working on the other one.
Thanks, Grayson. Got you. Thanks, Grayson.
Oh, that's,
Is that a 49?
No, that's such 49.
All right, let's talk about these guys. I'm a little bit concerned about one of these. So let's take a look at it and see. All right, first of all, let's look at the division problem. No question, I think we're going to change it into... Stop talking. Listen, focus. We're going to change it into improper fractions. So negative 49 fourths and 11 thirds. Perfect. It's a division problem, so he flipped the second one over and he did his multiplication. So he did 49 times 3, got 147, 4 times 11, got 44, and he made it negative because we're multiplying a negative times a positive. If I were grading this paper, it would be A plus. That is an A plus. Does anybody have a question about that?
No.
All right, now this one. This one is harder because in addition, you have to have a common denominator, right?
Yeah.
Now, this is one of those cases where I think it is much safer to do improper fractions than it is to leave it as mixed numbers. Here is why. This is essentially a subtraction problem because you have a negative and a positive, and you cannot subtract 8 from 3, so you didn't do your borrowing. So this one isn't right. Let's do what Navi did. Let's change it into improper fractions. So it would be the same ones, negative 49 fourths plus 11 thirds. What is our common denominator? 12. So we're going to multiply this one by 3 and this one by 4. Now that's, what did Navi get? Negative 147 over 12 plus 44 over 12. Now we can add them together, but since one's a negative, we're actually going to subtract. So negative 103 over 12?
Yeah.
That is your final answer.
What would it be as a mixed number?
As a mixed number, it would be negative 8 and 7 twelfths. Okay? All right, let's try one more. Let's get one more up here.
Can I redeem us?
Well, it depends if anybody else wants to come up.
Can I do a division problem?
No, we're gonna do a different kind of problem here. All right, so I need two volunteers.
Oh, yeah.
I need new ones, but if no new ones come, Brandon, you can come back.
Good, no.
The wonder one.
They were solving these equations. All right, here we go. We're solving, come on, Ben, you got one. Anybody else want one? All right, Hope. Brandon, you can do it over there on the sideboard if you want.
Oh, which one?
Whichever one you want. Come on, Hope. No, you're doing that one. He's doing it on the sideboard.
Yeah, I'm like, kind of best.
Well, hurry up. I don't care. Now, we're all busy doing these problems. Kyle, that would be you too. You have them done already? Okay, well, let's write them down and get them done. Math is not a spectator sport. We have practice.
Math league is a sport.
Okay, now, I am not picking on Hope. I love Hope. But this is one of those things where if we don't write it down, actually, you did great, but I want you to write it down. This is x plus 3 equals negative 11. I want you to write that step down. Now, Hope did exactly the right thing. She subtracted 3 and got negative 14. That is the correct answer. Good job. But some of you, because you refuse to write this step down, you are making careless mistakes. That problem should be easy points. There are enough hard problems. This is an easy one. But not if you rush through it. You do stupid stuff and you end up missing a point. Just take your time, write it down. This is the correct answer. Good work, Hope. Now, who did this? Who said me? Ben? All right, so Ben subtracted 4 from both sides. Was that the right thing to do first?
Yes.
Yes. X divided by 8 plus 4. So we minus 4. So x divided by 8 equals 6. Then he times by 8. So x equals 48. Perfect. Now, Brandon, is this what?
Well, I got it wrong.
All right. Now, kids, those are the kinds of problems that you absolutely have to get right on your exam. Don't mess around and miss those easy, easy things. Okay, let me hand out your homework.